Well, it is the first of its kind effort by the state of Maine to deal with a growing number of cases of Alzheimer's disease. That illness affects more than 37,000 people here in Maine, and with an aging population, that number is expected to go up significantly over the next 5 to 10 years. News 8's Meghan Torjussen is here now with more on what the state hopes to do. Meghan?
Tracy, today's announcement was the outcome of nearly a year of work on the part of this task force. One of the key elements of this plan, detection and diagnosis, something caregivers often say is the hardest part.
Everyone that met her, her laugh, she was funny, very outgoing, very positive, just, I mean, she was great.
Sally Tart took care of her mom, Connie Rue, before losing her to Alzheimer's disease last December. Rue loved adventure and watching the Celtics.
I think the hardest part was getting her diagnosed because you think it's old age or you think it's, oh, she's just being silly.
To help other families cope with Alzheimer's, Tart established a Kennebunk-based nonprofit called A Place to Start. She's also a member of the task force that developed the state's first comprehensive plan to educate people about all that comes along with this debilitating disease.
It must be considered and addressed as part of the public health issue and leading towards crisis.
According to the Alzheimer's Association, 1 in 8 people 65 or older has Alzheimer's. And in Maine, that population is expected to grow 77% in the next 10 years.
Alzheimer's is not going away, and deaths are rising.
The state's first comprehensive plan to confront the disease was announced today. Maine becomes the 23rd state to adopt such a plan. Some specifics include public awareness campaigns, making sure the disease falls under chronic conditions under the Affordable Care Act, and studying financing for long-term care for patients. All positive steps, Sally Tart says, would make a daily struggle that much easier.
I think you have no idea until you go through it, really, because it's constant.
This is especially important because the CDC says Maine is the oldest state in the nation. If you'd like more information or more specifics, or if you have any questions, visit the As Seen On section of our website, WMTW.com. In the newsroom, Meghan Torjussen, News 8.